Hello there, my name is Nasrallo and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Now, in this video, we'll briefly talk about Bitcoin, about quantitative tightening, and then we're going to talk about an insane token that could do 10x. And I'm going to tell you exactly how not to get burned on token listings and what you should look for if you want to find that, you know, 10x coin, and how not to FOMO in into something that is bound to go down. A small spoiler alert, and even if the coin looks very, very appealing. So without any further ado, Thomas Krallo is a birthday boy today. So it's my birthday, 28th birthday. So I'm still making the video for you guys and girls. And after I make a video, I'm going to go enjoy life with my family and friends. So make some noise down in the comments. And the best gift from you, my lovely YouTube community, for my birthday is going to be a like on this video and a nice, beautiful comment down in the comment section. And thank you very much in advance. And as always, if you're brand new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button and also hit that notification bell so that you're always notified when I make a new upload. And also down in the description of this video, there is a link to my free Telegram channel where we discuss a lot of super cool stuff. Join it. It's very useful for any beginner or experienced trader. And without any further ado, let's just jump right into it. So, birthdays being birthdays, and me being a birthday boy, I have a very good mood today, and I have to fly to Istanbul, actually, later tonight. But nonetheless, let's talk about this. So basically with Bitcoin, we saw this incredible pump, and right now if we're going to go to 4-hour chart, we're going to see that, let me remove the indicators, we're going to see that we have very strong support and very strong resistance right here in this area, and this is the deciding moment right now. And I think that Bitcoin currently is waiting for the market open, and it wants to really perhaps see what's going to happen once Fed is going to start quantitative tightening finally, and we're going to talk about this in just a second. So in this area, our main resistance, and I told you about this, guys and girls, yesterday, so call me Mr. Spot On down in the comments, and birthday Mr. Spot On. So I told you about this before yesterday, that our very important key market level is 32,160 from right here. That's where it came from, and we are seeing a lot of resistance from it now. So if you have taken some scalp trades here, congratulations. And our main support currently right here in this super short term perspective is $31,444 right there, which is super cool, and it's holding us really well right now. So really have to see what's going to happen. A 4-hour close with some volume below it would signal a very interesting short trade opportunity, in my personal opinion, with a target, the first target of 30,600, then about 30,000, and then the next one obviously being 28,700. So now I think three take profit areas would be very nice. And if you would take the short trade, the stop loss can be very short, something like 31,700 or even 31,600, and like 5-to-1 or 10-to-1 take profit to stop loss ratio would be amazing. And of course, very important about quantitative tightening, that the Fed's quantitative tightening is about to arrive, and etc. If you can read about this online, but basically they're gonna be selling off their huge portfolio, which is currently like $9 trillion, and they're gonna start reducing it on Wednesday. And of course, obviously, guys and girls, we'll see what happens. Of course, the market has already priced it in, but I mean, this kind of a selling pressure can also have, you know, will create some kind of a resistance for the price to climb anywhere, and that's gonna affect primarily NASDAQ and S&P 500. And of course, we know that Bitcoin is highly correlated with those two as being the highest risk asset. So for that reason, as I told you before, I'm not really seeing Bitcoin just suddenly for no bloody reason to take off and, you know, go to space and reclaim its all-time high, whatever. The best, absolute best case scenario that I can see is the retest of 36,000 because of this breakout, maybe. But even that, I think, is a bit unreasonable at this point with what we're seeing and with what the Fed is going to be doing. I would not be, as I said in the previous video, I would not be surprised if we will see this kind of a fake out to go lower and, you know, consolidate here for some bit of time. That would, in my honest, humble opinion, not financial advice, would make more sense. So this is something that we wanted to discuss about Bitcoin. Let's close it and let's talk about this. Optimism! Yeah, well, that's funny. But actually, you can check it out. It's at optimism.io. It's an incredible project, layer 2 project, which actually, you know, I learned about it recently. I studied it, and it's a really good project, right? So it's not one of those shit coins that is going to pump and dump. So this is a very strong project. And by the way, also, Bybit has was the first to list it, basically. And Bybit also has a cool price pool for those who deposit Optimism tokens to Bybit. So use my link down in the description of this video. Register with Bybit if you're so inclined. Bybit is a really great platform with amazing liquidity, super low fees, and incredible trading experience in general. And you can literally trade anything there. They also have a launchpad. They also have NFTs, DeFi, and all the altcoins you can imagine, and inverse perpetual contracts, futures, spot market, everything that you want. And with my link, you'll get up to $4,100 in free bonuses on top of your initial deposit, also for 30 days 0% maker fees, and you'll be able to participate in this insane 50,000 USDT giveaway if you deposit a minimum of 200 OP tokens into your spot account. So, and you can claim insane prizes on top of the prizes that I've just mentioned. So it's like total prize pool is insane. So use my link down in the comments or in the pinned down in the description or in the pinned comment. Okay, so, and yeah, you can use this insane thing. And Bybit was the first to list brand new Luna, which was insane, and also the first to list this Optimism token. So what is the Optimism token? So basically, the Optimism token is one of several projects working to help Ethereum scale by building out the network's layer 2 ecosystem. And it achieves this by leveraging optimistic rollups, a form of cryptographic technology that bundles transactions together to reduce the traffic load on Ethereum mainnet, along with ZK rollups and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So it's supposed to help Ethereum scale. And we already know that Ethereum is going to be moving to proof of stake, which is already a huge catalyst event if it goes as planned in the testnet on June 8th, so in about a week from today, which is insane. Now, the question is, you know, of course, Bybit, they already have it right here. So as you can see, it opened up at about 50 cents a token. It just literally skyrocketed to $14, and then it just went all the way down to 80 cents. And the question is, you know, Thomas, is this a pump and dump bullshit? And the thing is that in reality, you have to understand how token listings work, because OP, the Optimism token, was first listed just on Bybit. And you have to understand the way how it works, how any launch really works. And for that reason, I decided to make this video, so leave a like and a comment down below to explain what are the super basics that you have to look at when you're considering to buy a token at any listing. You have to understand that there are shit coins, and then there are really good projects, like, for example, the Optimism project. But there are sometimes even shit coins pump at listing, and you can make like 10x in like 5 minutes, which is rare, but it sometimes happens. While some good projects actually dump at listing, and the things that affect what's going to happen to the coin. And by the way, you can go to optimism.io, and I'm not associated with them, so you can check them out and see all the things that they're doing. It's really cool, and the stuff that they're bringing to the table is absolutely insane. So, and what you have to look is, of course, at the project itself. You can evaluate it, blah blah blah. But let's assume that you found a good project. You know that it's really good, etc. Like fundamentally in terms of what they're doing, etc. But that's not the only thing that you have to be looking at. What you have to look at is, for example, when there is any token listing in general, is it a bull run or is it a bear market? So when it's a bear market, there isn't really that very much liquidity. You know, everybody is scared and there isn't as much money flowing in. So the likelihood of an insane pump is already less. But that's something that is obvious. Now we have to talk about something that is less obvious. And that is, for example, what the token is doing within their governance, so to speak, and how are they, how is this, you know, listing happening? And here you will see that, let me just quickly find it right here. Basically, while the team initially allocated 5% of the 4.3 billion supply to the first airdrop, it promised that there would be an entire season of airdrops dipping into the further 15% of the total supply. So far, it's yet to announce details of any further airdrops. And this is is not good. So, right, so when we have more airdrops coming, that means that there's gonna be more pressure on the price, which is in turn is going to create more opportunity down the road, in my personal opinion, unless we're going to see, you know, some insane liquidity coming in right now and just sweeping up the, all the tokens for whatever reason and they're taking the tokens to some other prices. But so far it seems like, you know, this drop, why did it happen? You have to understand how, you know, the launch of any project works. When it's the token is not listed anywhere, it's actually being distributed and allocated to developers, to some early investors, to a bunch of people who have access to these kinds of things that me and you, for example, don't have access to. So when it gets listed, a certain portion, usually it depends on how they're doing it, a certain portion of the tokens are gonna actually get unlocked, so they're gonna actually take their profits. So while all the small fish and all the idiots are trying to get into, you know, thinking, oh, this is an insane project, and bringing the liquidity to the market, so bringing the money to the market, basically. This is what, you know, some early investors, etc., will be using to get out of the portions of their investments. So and that's what happened here. Basically, some people were buying in while other more people were selling. So that's why it went down. But it doesn't mean that it's a bad project. It means just that the initial launch with an airdrop that they've done has created more selling pressure. It just doesn't really diminish the project that much. It's just that you have to understand how they're releasing it so that you don't get in at $14 and then, you know, basically lose pretty much all of your money. So for that instance, that's the thing number one that you have to really pay attention to, the airdrops, and understand that with subsequently when they're going to have 14% more allocated to further airdrops that yet to be announced, that means there's going to be a lot more selling pressure of those who are going to be just trying to take some money out of it. So for that reason, I would wait on this token. And a good measure is always also, and this is a huge tip for you guys in growth. And by the way, I cover all of my tips in great detail at thomascrollo.com at my 5 months long certified and accredited trading learning programs, where you learn everything from on-chain analysis, fundamental analysis, technical analysis. You'll learn how to day trade, swing trade, scalp trade, how to do long-term investing, how to build portfolios, how to manage your trading psychology, how to manage your money, risk and money management, and how to keep proper trading statistics, how to transition properly to real money trading, all of it in one place. And you also get a certified diploma from Tom Scrollo. So also go directly to thomascrollo.com and use the code 20OFF and get yourself a nice discount. Or there's also some links down in the description as well as in the pinned comment, and enjoy. And I cover these things in detail in my full learning program. But one of the important metrics that you have to look at as well is their competition. So you take OP token. Okay, that's great. They're doing something with layer two and they're providing a lot of potentially a lot of value to Ethereum itself. So it could actually explode together with Ethereum. All of that is great. But what you have to understand is that are they the only ones who are doing this? And of course, and they're participating in layer two, etc. Of course, the answer is going to be no. There are many predecessors and a lot of the competition in the market. It's not 2015 anymore. There are literally like 20,000 tokens out there. So you have to make sure that the competition, that you know of the competition and what they're doing and how, what is the valuation, what happened to their price, etc. So for that reason, for example, when it comes to Optimism, for example, you can go to CoinGecko. Oh, see my ads right there. You can learn trade. I can actually click and learn from myself right here. That's quite interesting. So anyway, you can click or go to CoinGecko and in check out all the details, like for example, market capitalization, which is very important. We're going to talk about it in just a second. Then what's going to be very important in circulating supply. So how many tokens are currently in circulation? So Bybit is the first one to list Optimism, and some tokens are circulating here and there as more exchanges are adding it, etc. And you know, and with more airdrops, the circulating supply is going to grow. And then you have to measure it in accordance to the total supply. So how many tokens are going to be there in total? Like we know, for example, with Bitcoin, the total will be 21 million, while currently there is like pretty much like 20 million or whatever. So it's like only a small fraction is left of what is going to be added to the circulating supply. So the same thing is here. You know, you're seeing that, well, actually it's the complete opposite. You'll see that the total supply is much, much greater. Only about 5% is in circulating supply. So that means if they would add all of their total supply to circulation, the price would go really fast, really low. So this is something you really have to pay attention to. And of course, the market capitalization, and you have to compare it to their competition. So you have to really check how big are their competitors, and that is going to give you an understanding of what can you potentially expect from any given coin. So for example, let's take a look at this Loopring LRC. This is their direct competitor, and as you can see here, and this is a very good example, guys and girls. So here you will see that the total supply is 1.373 billion tokens, and in the circulating supply they already have like 1.245. So almost all of it, close to all of it, is already in circulating supply. So we cannot really expect any dilution happening, and you know, this is a good number that we are seeing here. And then also we can take a look at the total market cap, which is 700 million with this kind of circulating supply, which is very close to the total supply. So when you're looking at this and you're comparing it to what you're seeing here with circulating supply being 5% of the total supply, this means that the price could still go down like 20 times if there would be, you know, the total supply would be in circulation, like we are seeing with their competitor Loopring right here. And of course the market cap, so they already have half of their of the market cap of their competitor Loopring. So that gives us an idea of, you know, the potential. So if we would see here market cap of 30 million and then, you know, circulating supply of, I don't know, 3.5 billion instead of 215 million, maybe we would say, yeah, this is a 10x opportunity in the short term perspective, whatever. But when you're seeing the numbers that we're seeing, you're starting to, you know, really doubt that there could be this kind of an explosive opportunity. Of course, in short-term perspective, anything can happen, but this would be, these kinds of fundamentals would make me stay away from it, because I wanted to buy some token of optimism, because it's optimistic, but at the same time, when you see these details, you lose interest, really. Then another one would be Boba Network. It's also their direct competitor, and in this instance, the total supply is 500 million, and the circulating supply currently is 159 million. So it's about, let's say, what, 30%? So it's, again, it's not as good as with, for example, with Loopring, but still 30% in circulation. And market cap is actually 79 million only. So they already have much higher market cap than their competitors. You know, a lot of people make a huge mistake saying that, well, you know, Bitcoin has $500 billion in market cap. Yes, but Bitcoin is Bitcoin, currently at least, but Bitcoin is Bitcoin, and these kinds of tokens are all altcoins, right? So they're very tiny, and a lot of them never climb even to $1 billion of market cap. So not even close to being, you know, 0.1% of Bitcoin's market cap. And that's absolutely fine. So expecting that some coin that even has some potential within the industry and the market that it's focused on improving, even if it's good and it could potentially be explosive, it doesn't mean that it can reach, you know, $10 billion of market capitalization like one of those top altcoins. So keep that in mind. And yeah, if you want to buy some for long-term purposes, again, I think that this is not the time, but I could be wrong. So, and you can do it on Bybit, and using my link, you'll get a nice bonus on top of it. And you can also trade it actively. So if you believe it's going to go lower, which it's very likely that it will, then you can short it under derivatives right here on Bybit as well. And thank you very much for watching. Let me know down in the comments, what do you think about this coin? Make some more noise for Mr. Spot On being 20 year, 1 year older today. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.